So you want to... Obviously, this is an evolving situation, you know. Right now, the latest report this morning from China that there's about 800, well, a little bit more than 800 cases and 26 deaths. So it's still continuing to evolve. As you know, there it's now in 29 out of 31 provinces in China, and the Chinese not only have closed off the transportation, public transportation from Wuhan, but also from a number of other cities, several cities there have been. And you know, the State Department is now has a level 4 for Wuhan, essentially no travel to Wuhan. So obviously we're taking this very seriously. I don't think this is something that the United States public should be worried or frightened about, but they should know that we are taking this obviously very seriously as it evolves. It's really a big difference with the Chinese this time now than I was there with the SARS situation I experienced. They were not transparent then, and it was an embarrassment for them, and it was very difficult because it slowed things down. This time around, to my perception, they look like they're being quite transparent and cooperative with us. Mm-hmm. I don't think we possibly could do in the United States. I can't imagine shutting down New York or Los Angeles, but the judgment on the part of the Chinese health authorities is that given the fact that it's spreading throughout the provinces, 29 out of 31 provinces, it's their judgment that this is something that in fact is going to help in containing it. Whether or not it does or does not is really open to question, because historically, when you shut things down, it doesn't necessarily have a major effect. But I think we just need to keep an open mind. It's their decision. Hopefully it'll work. We will go into phase one testing. That doesn't mean it's available for distribution, but phase one testing is the first stage, and that will start almost certainly within 3 months, and then it'll take 3 months from then to determine if it's safe and if it induces the kind of response that you would like it to induce. That's the first step. We don't want people to get confused to think that we're going to have a vaccine available for people in 3 months, but the initial stages of testing will start in 3 months. I think the risk is very low right now for the United States. The thing that what you need to be watching out for is sustained person-to-person transmission. The fact that someone gets infected and infects someone else, that you can see even with a virus that isn't efficient. But when you get primary, secondary, tertiary, and continue, then you have to be more concerned. We have not seen that, not only here, but we have not seen that even in the other countries that have been infected. For example, South Korea, Japan, Thailand, and those places, there have been cases, but they're all travel-related cases. I don't think in general healthcare providers in the country should be screening, but one of the things that's really simple, we're in the middle of a flu season, people are going to be coming in with symptoms that are very similar to a SARS. Ask a simple question. Have you traveled to this region of China, or have you come into contact with someone who has? And if the answer is no, then you're probably almost certainly dealing with flu.